It is day 9 here in Gwangju at the Summer University Games, and the rains are coming down very heavily. If you look at the Universiade Cauldron. From athletics last night, we'll take a look at many events, including men's discus and women's shot put. We'll go inside to the women's volleyball gold medal match between Ukraine and Russia. We also have women's semifinal water polo action, Russia taking on the Australians. We'll move over to Taekwondo, where 4 gold medals were handed out last night. Tennis action moved inside. The men's doubles final took place. We also had an incredible basketball game between the United States and Japan in women's semifinal play. Athletics from yesterday. There's a look at the Gwangju Universiade main stadium. Looks really sunny in that shot, but the rains came later in the day, as you can see here. This is the women's triple jump, and you're looking at Anna Jagaciak-Michalska of Poland. She won an earlier silver here at Universiade in long jump. And there she jumps 13.81 meters on her final attempt. Now we look at Jenny Elbe of Germany. Competed in Shenzhen at Universiade in 2011. She was 8th there. Look back here at her 4th attempt. 13.86 meters for her. That would set the pace. Now we look at Ekaterina Konyeva of Russia. She's the 2-time defending gold medalist at Universiade in this competition. Also was 2nd at the Worlds in 2013. And there she will put in a distance of 14.60. And that will put her atop the podium. Gold medal for Konyeva. Elbe wins silver and Jagaciak-Michalska the bronze. Now to the men's discus. Here's Andrius Gudzius of Lithuania. This is his 2nd attempt. He won the European Under 23 Championships in 2013. And there's a throw for him of 62.54 meters. And now the Australian Matthew Denny. His 4th attempt, his best so far, 62.11 meters. And a really solid throw there for the Australian. 62.58 meters. That's a personal best for him. Now Philip Milanov of Belgium. This on his 2nd attempt. A huge throw for him. 64.15 meters. There you get a good slow motion look at it. And that'll put him atop the podium. Gold medal. Philip Milanov of Belgium. Matthew Denny the silver. And Andrius Gudzius the bronze. On to the women's shot put. This is Brittany Crew of Canada. Competes at home for the York University Lions in Toronto. And she loves that throw. That's a personal best, 17.27 meters. You see the rains driving down there for the Canadian coaches. Now on to Paulina Guba of Poland. 5th earlier this year at the European Indoor Championships. And she too will have a personal best, 17.94 meters. Now the 2nd attempt we'll look at here from Lena Urbaniak of Germany. 8th at last year's European Championships. And a big, big throw for her, 18 meters. Also a personal best. So the 3 medalists each set personal best here today. Urbaniak sits on top. Gooba second, and the Canadian Crew is third. Now to the final event in the women's heptathlon. This is the second of two heats in the 800 meters. In this heat is Ida Markussen of Norway. She's competed at two Olympics, four world championships, and was sixth in this event in Kazan at Universiade. There you see her. She will power ahead in her heat to win it in a time of 2 minutes, 11.70 seconds. But the winner of the heptathlon, Anna Maywald of Germany, there you see her. Markussen will win the silver, and Anna Petrick of Russia, the bronze. Gold medal women's volleyball last night at the UAMJU Gymnasium. Ukraine taking on Russia. The USSR won 6 gold before the country split. Russia has won 2 since, including in Kazan. Ukraine has never medaled. Russia would win the 2 first sets quite easily. We're now in the third. This is Zaryashko to serve, and it can't be handled. She was on that 2013 Kazan gold medal winning team. Here she is again to serve. Ukraine sets it up for Anastasia Chernuka, but that attack cannot get through Malkova. You see it there off her left arm. Zaryashko again to serve. And Russia with a great effort here defensively. It ends up on the arm of Voronkova. She gets it off the Ukrainian block and out. Now here's Kodola to serve for Ukraine. 6-2 Russia leading. And Daria Isieva with the kill there. 7-2 Russia. Here's Filistinskaya of Russia to serve. And that one can't be handled there by number 16, Kodola. Here's Isieva to serve for the Russians. 19-12 right now, they lead. There's the overhit from Ukraine, and Filistinskaya with the kill. Now 23-14. Great dig there from Pisarenko. And they will set it up here for her. And there's the kill down the middle. We're at match point now, 24-14. Ukraine, though, would battle hard. Another match point. And Pisarenko there, off the Ukrainian block and out. Russia will win its second straight gold medal and its third as an independent country at Universiade. Huge effort for them, 25-12, 25-17, 25-17. Ukraine wins the silver and Japan the bronze. Women's water polo semifinal from yesterday at the UAMJU Indoor Aquatics Center. Australia taking on Russia. Australia has never medaled in women's water polo in the 3 previous times it's been at Universiade. Russia are the defending gold medalists and also won bronze in 2009 and 2011. Early on, it is Russia in the lead, 2-0 right now. And there's a great shot from well out. Polomakova scores there. It's now 3-0 Russia. 3-1 now. Abdraziakova with a great goal there. And the Russians now up by 3 again. Moving on to the second period. 4-2 the Russians in front. Nice pass there from Tiana Sogard-Anderson to Fiona Walsh. Now 4-3. Really gets the ball right in front, and a foul committed there. And off of that, Australia will score. That's Jessica Zimmerman, who knotted at 4. There you see the Australian team talking things over. Into the third period, 6-5, the Australians now ahead. A nice shot to the top corner. That's Polomakova again. It's tied at 6. This one going back and forth. Penalty called on Russia. And Australia takes advantage. Isabel Bishop scores to put the Aussies up one. And they'll get their first two-goal lead of the game right here, as they will set up Elodie Ruffin. And she'll skip that one home. 8-6, the Aussies in front. They'd build on that lead. They'll work the ball right in front. There you see it. Elle Armit able to put that one home. 9-6. You get a good replay of it here. The stop made, but the Russian keeper couldn't find it. And there's one off the post from Mihailovic. Russia will recover the ball. And just as an Australian penalty ends, Zubkova scores to get Russia back within two. Time ticking down, but a minute and a half to go. And Søgaard Andersen will score there, and that might do it, putting Australia up 10-7 with 1 minute and 30 seconds left. Russia with one last chance there, stopped by Hedges. Time ticks down. Australia will head off to the gold medal match. Russia will play for bronze here in women's water polo. And there you look at the Chosun University Gymnasium from yesterday, four Taekwondo gold medal matches. First up, the women's under 62 kilo class. This one features Erem Yaman of Turkey and Zhang Hua of China. Yaman actually won gold at this year's World Championships, while Zhang was the 2014 Asian champion. Zhang would lead 1-0 after the first round, while Yaman would lead 2-1 after the second. You see it here right now, 6-3 in favor of Yaman. But Zhang will score three. And Zhang would get one more to win this gold medal, 7-6. Erem Yaman will win the silver. Gabagi of Ivory Coast and Calvo Gomez of Spain each win bronze. Now the women's over 73 kilo class from Iran, Akram Kotabande taking on Kim Bikna of Korea. Kotabande won silver at the 2014 Asian Games, and Kim was third at last year's Student World Championships. This one would be very close through the first two rounds, tied at one. And then in the third round, as you see there, points scored by Kotabande, she would take over this bout. Score right now 9-3, and that's how it will end. Akram Kotabande for Iran wins gold. Kim from Korea wins silver. And the bronze medals go to Ikieva of Russia and Simone Alamo of Spain. Now the men's side, the heavyweights over 87 kilos. From Uzbekistan, Dmitry Shokin, he's in blue, is taking on Park Yoon-kun of Korea in red. Shokin's had a good year already, won gold at this year's World Championships. No score through the first two rounds. You see there, Shokin scores one. And now a second. He's up 2-0 here in the third round. Park would counter back with one. But time will tick away on the Korean. Dmitry Shokin of Uzbekistan, the gold medalist in the men's over 87 kilo class. Park wins silver. You see Shokin there congratulating Park. Askari of Iran and DeAndre of Brazil each win bronze medals. And the final match from last night, this is the men's under 74 kilo class. Sayed Khosrafar of Iran taking on Toran Mezroy of France. Khosrafar in blue, Mezroy in red. 3-0 right now, Khosrafar leading. That's how it would be after the first round. They would each score a point in the second. And here now in the third round. Tied up. But Kozrafar will go ahead. He's up 7-6. Very animated athlete there in Kozrafar. And he escapes almost literally 8-7. He will win the gold medal. Mezois of France, silver. Glesman and Ustayev each win bronze. The men's doubles tennis final from yesterday. This is the Yuamju Indoor Tennis Court. This was not the original venue, but because of the rains, they had to move inside to play this match. As you see here in the second set, we're looking at Chung Hyun and Nam Ji-sung of Korea. They're taking on Joseph Salisbury and Darren Walsh of Great Britain. Korea won the opening set 6-2. As you saw, 2-0 here in the second set for the Brits. At the net there in blue, in the glasses, that is Chung Hyun. He recently competed in singles at Wimbledon, losing in the first round. And earlier this year was ranked 68th in the world in singles. So he has had a meteoric rise in men's singles tennis. The second set would be 6-3 in favor of Britain. You see the Brits serving. And a great volley there at the net for the point for Great Britain. This third set would require extra games. There you see Chung with the backhand. And Great Britain, 10-8 in the third set. They win this match 2-1. Nam and Chung win silver. Japan and Chinese Taipei each take bronze. From last night, an epic basketball game. Women's semifinal, U.S. and Japan. U.S. looking for its fourth straight gold medal. Japan looking for its second ever appearance in the gold medal game. Here in the first quarter, Japan up big, 26-11 off that three-pointer from Masumi Honda. Now Manami Fujioka takes it hard to the rim. At the half, Japan will be up 43-36. Here in the second half, the U.S. has closed the gap. And there's a turnover by Japan. Courtney Williams almost turns it over herself, but she finds Nina Davis for two. Then right after, out of camera view, Sydney Weiss with the steal, and she'll pot another couple. After three, Japan was up 58-57. Here in the fourth, there's a steal from Ariel Powers, and she'll take it in for the layup. Now late in the fourth, under 20 seconds to go, Japan down by two. They clear out, and a great crossover there from Fujioka. She gets it to the rim. We're tied at 77. U.S. inbounds the ball, looks inside, but there's a steal for Japan. A chance to win it. But another steal by the Americans. Mercedes Russell, as time ticks down, no, it won't fall for her. Couple turnovers late, creating opportunities, but we'll head to overtime. There's a great spin dribble there from Mio Shinozaki of Japan for the score. And the Americans have some difficulty inbounding the ball here. No foul call there, and that'll be a turnover to Japan. They would not capitalize, though. Both coaches looking on. Now under a minute to go, and Powers, that right foot, steps on the sideline. She'll turn the ball over to Japan. U.S. up by two. Now Shinozaki goes quick to the rim. Scores and is fouled. Chance for Japan to take the lead, but she will miss on that free throw. Now the U.S. back the other way. slowing things down here. Shot clock and game clock pretty much even. U.S. sets up the screen for Canada. She will take it to the rim. That one won't fall. Russell with the chance. Won't fall either, but there's a foul right there on the rebound. Erica McCall, a chance to go to the line and win it. Misses there on the first. And long on the second. She is furious with herself, and that'll send us off to a second overtime. There, though, Canada with a great pass inside to McCall, and in traffic, she finishes it. U.S. up by two. Now time ticking down on the shot clock. Courtney Williams pulls up, and she'll knock it down. 90-86, the Americans in front. They would control much of the second overtime. Up here by three, Williams with the free throw. That puts them up four, and that'll pretty much do it. The United States in an outstanding basketball game against Japan. They win 102-98 and will now head to their 16th gold medal game against Canada. Canada making their first ever appearance seeking gold.